Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today I'm going to show you how to reinstall the lower unit to our 40 horsepower four-stroke Mercury engine. Now we've already done several procedures to this lower unit, and if you need help with yours, why don't you check out that playlist, and I pretty much bet we've already done it. So let me go grab a couple of just basic hand tools and I'll show you how to get this thing remounted and hooked back up. So let's go. Before we unbolt it, let's go ahead and get some grease on the input spline and then just a little bit on this water tube where it installs a little bit easier. Now when you bring this over, make sure you've already got access to one of these bolts so it'll hold it in place. And away we go. There we go. But when you're doing this, make sure you can push it all the way up just by hand. You don't want to use the bolts to pull it into position, because if you're having to do that, you're doing it wrong and you're going to end up either bending or breaking something. We're just going to bottom these out, and then we're going to come back and torque them. Now let's go ahead and torque down those four, and we need to take it to 40 foot-pounds. Now the front two are easy because the torque wrench can get in there without a problem. But now what do we do about this? Well, let me show you a special tool that'll help straighten that out. This little guy right here will attach to a regular box end wrench and then allow you to go to the torque wrench. Now the real trick with this one is, as long as you're at a 90 degree position from the wrench itself, you can just use the regular torque values. Now if you go off of that 90 degrees, there's a formula that you have to use to calculate what the foot-pounds should be. And it doesn't matter which distance you are here, that has no bearing on it. Make sure we're at 90 degrees. And now, pretty cool, huh? Here we go, which is a 15 millimeter. This one is 40 foot-pounds as well. Have our little grate right here, need to get it back in. Now we can get our new trim tab on there, because the other one was broken, if you remember. And we're just gonna set it at a zero, because we don't have a point of reference on this one, or the one that came off, because it was broken. And this one is going to be 16 foot-pounds. Next, let's go ahead and lower it back down. We'll get the shift shaft reconnected, and then we'll pretty much be done with this one. All right, what we're doing is we're going to take that pin right here and put it into the top of the shift shaft. It looks like it's fairly close, but not quite. Oh, there it goes. All we did was just slide the pin in, and now we just take it and rotate it down, and that locks it in position. Well, all right, guys, that wraps this one up. Well, listen, if you need any parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net, and we can get you taken care of. Have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below, and I'll do my best to answer them. If you like what you see, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.